Omar Sharif, Why Google Honors Him Today. Hailed by many as the noble, Sharif would have been 86 years old today. In honor of his birthday, Google is changing its logo in 48 countries to an illustration of Omar Sharif. This is a snapshot of his story. Early steps. Born in 1932 to Syrian Lebanese parents in Alexandria, Egypt, Sharif's birth name was Michel Dimitri Shaloub. Before becoming an actor, he graduated with a degree in mathematics and physics from Cairo University and worked for several years at his father's lumber company. He left the family business and went on to study acting at the Royal Academy of Dramatic Art in London, Britain's capital. In 1954, he began his acting career and starred in films with one of Egypt's leading actresses, Fatin Hamama. In 1955, he converted to Islam, changed his name to Omar Sharif, and married Fatin soon after. They had a son, Tarek, before separating in 1966 and divorcing in 1974. Despite Sharif's image as an eligible bachelor, he did not remarry, saying he never fell in love with another woman. International fame. Sharif appeared in a number of Egyptian films before the British director David Lean added him to the cast of Lawrence of Arabia. Sharif played the role of an Arab warrior. The scene showing his arrival is considered a classic piece of cinema. He first appears as a tiny dot in the desert horizon, growing larger as his camel gallops into the frame with Peter O'Toole. His performance brought him an Oscar nomination for Best Supporting Actor, propelling him to international fame. But international recognition came at a hefty personal price, as Sharif intimated in an interview with the Associated Press news agency in 2003. "It separated me from my wife, from my family. We didn't see each other anymore, and that was it, the end of our wedding," he said. "I might have been happier having stayed an Egyptian film star. I might have been happier having stayed an Egyptian film star." Career struggles. After winning a third Golden Globe Award for acting in Dr. Zhivago, Sharif's career went downhill. He attributed his change of film fortune to what he called the cultural revolution at the end of the 1960s, as new directors focused on making films about their own societies. There was no more room for a foreigner, so suddenly there were no more parts for him to act, Sharif said. He began appearing in films such as The Pink Panther Strikes Again, and others he dismissed as rubbish. "I lost my self-respect and dignity," he told a reporter in 2004. "Even my grandchildren were making fun of me. Grandpa, that was really bad. And this one? It's worse. I lost my self-respect and dignity."